Welcome to the Vector Garden. In this tutorial, we are going to create this kind of design in Illustrator. The special thing about this is when you move this around, this object goes with it. Now, of course, you could just create a rectangle and a circle and group that and then it moves, but that is not the case here. These objects are created dynamically, and we can check this out. So I'm going to select some text, copy it, and then just paste it. And you see this one gets longer with the text. And in here, I'm going to paste something as well. And you see that object moves down. And then, of course, when I make this column a little narrower, then that adjusts as well. So what can we do to create this? Now, in InDesign, this would be fairly simple to create some paragraph rulers, and then you have these lines. But in Illustrator, it's not quite as simple. So let's first start off with a text object, an area text, and then, of course, we need the appearance panel. So let's first go here and turn off the automatic spell check so we don't get these underlines and see our own paragraph rulers, of course. And then let's go to the appearance panel. In order to create this, what we need is an additional fill. Let's go here. We can't do this with a stroke because just open paths, straight paths, cannot be created using Illustrator effects. Now let's go here, and I'm going to make this red because then I can see it better. And this additional fill now takes the shape of the text, of course, and since it's on top of the characters, we see this in red. Now, we need to convert this to a rectangle. And in order to do that, use Effect, Convert to Shape, Rectangle, like this. And let's give that an extra height of 0. Of course, it needs to be relative to the size of that text box. And let's give it an extra width of 1 millimeter, like this. Now, yeah, this cannot work. But when we make the area larger, then of course that red rectangle adjusts. But it adjusts to the large area, to the large width of that area as well. So what we need to do is make that area narrower first. And we cannot just do it like this because we need the text, and we also need to move that rectangle to the left. Now, in order to get what we want, we need to introduce a transform effect. And let's go to Effect, Distort and Transform, and then let's transform that. And what we could, of course, do is just check this off and make horizontal scale. And you see, then of course we could get this narrow line, but that will not work very well if we do it like this, because the transform effect in this case gets applied afterwards, and when we make the area broader, then you see, of course, that rectangle adjusts its width as well, and that's not what we want. We need to do that differently. And for that, what we need to do is put transform before the rectangle, so it gets applied before we have the rectangle. And then what we need to do is go in here again, and first of all, we need to adjust this down here. And we need that we need to set that to the left. I'm going to set it to the top left, but we can set it to any of these. And then what we can do is make this 0%. So first of all, that complete area of the text gets scaled to 0%. And this is left at 100% because we need to have the complete height. And then what we can also do, because we need to move it to the left, like this, we move it to the left. So like this. What this transform effect creates is a rectangle that is 0% and is moved here. So it's basically just a line like this. This happens here and then our rectangle gets applied. Let's take a look at it again. And this makes it wider again. And we can make that a little smaller, just 0.3 millimeters like this. And then we have a line and that adjusts. Now we cannot stop here. I'm going to make that larger. That works. And it also works when I make it smaller. But what doesn't work is when I double click here and then start to have that area adjusted automatically to the length of the text, which also happens when you go into type, area type options, and have the auto size on. So that doesn't work. You see, it has already moved. And for this, what we can do is go into the fill again and then introduce another rectangle effect. So we have a new effect. And we set this to relative, just like this. So this creates a rectangle which has the same size as the area of the text, but it's just a rectangle. And this needs to be, let's check out which one it is. It's this one here. It needs to be before the transform effect. So first we make just a rectangle, nothing changed. Then we really change something using the transform effect. And then we introduce the width of that red rectangle. Okay, that is this one. And now that we know this, we can create the dot as well. So what we're going to do is have a new fill. It doesn't matter where it is actually. And then let's go in here and make a rectangle, just 0, and then have that transform effect in here. And this one we set to 0, 0. And you see everything vanishes because the transform effect is currently applied at the wrong space. Doesn't matter, we just leave it at that. And then we need to move it slightly and move it vertically as well, like this. And this one needs to be in the top left, actually, because that's where the point is going to be. And you see, this is why the text is gone. So let's get it and move it here, like this. Now, from that one, we need to make the circle. So let's just select this. Go to Effect, Convert to Shape, Ellipse, apply a new effect, and then let's have this 3 by 3 millimeters like this. And let's make this here, and you see there we get the circle. This can be adjusted now. So let's go into this transform effect again. We need this value. I'm going to set this to 4 just to have a nice round value and go in here and set this to -4 as well and in here as well like this. So we get it nice and centered and then we go in here and make that a little smaller, still smaller. Just an elegant, nice point up there like this. And then let's try that out. I'm going to move that down. And you see, this works well. So to get this one, we basically need the same methods. But this needs to be adjusted, such as like hard-coded for a specific point size in that headline. So let's start with the text object and make that headline and make that size for the headline like this. And then, of course, we need to introduce some space after that. And in there, we're going to get that line like this. And then let's take this, introduce the new fill, and let's make that red again. And then let's go to Effect and make this into a rectangle. And again, let's make our little trick. And the next thing is we need that transform effect. And let's make this, the vertical scale needs to be 0, but horizontally we need 100%, the full width of that area. And then we need to set this to the top left, of course. And you see there's already that line. And then we need to move that. That just needs to be adjusted like this. That's okay. And then we need another convert to shape, another rectangle. And this time, what we need is an extra width of 0 and an extra height. Let's make this 1 millimeter like this and just figure out which one it is. It needs to be there. And then we can still say, okay, this can be smaller. And then it looks more elegantly, such as this. And then we have that line. Of course, when this text gets larger, then we need to adjust these as well. Let's put that square in the bottom and let's just have another fill for that. And I'm going to duplicate this. Just drag it over here, and then we can go into the transform effect, put this to here. So this needs to be that reference point, such as that one. And then we are going to maybe move that slightly to the right and to the bottom, but that can be adjusted later on. And this needs to be 0%, like this. Then we go in here, and then we go into that one. And let's make this like 3 millimeter. And there we have that rectangle. And then we can go into the transform effect again and adjust the position. Let's set this to 0. And then let's move this up again. And you see, we need to adjust this further. We have 4 by 4 millimeters, so this needs to be -2 so that it gets adjusted to the right side of that. And that's how you can adjust it and get it down there, like so. So that's how you can generate text decorations in Illustrator, like slightly what you can do in InDesign. And of course, when you need some more than that, then it's better to use InDesign for that, really.